Hi, my name is Leo Rivera. I'm a soil scientist and the director of scientific outreach here at Meter Group. And today we are going to talk about hydraulic conductivity and the things you need to know to understand the measurement. And for this first part, we're going to focus on some of the fundamentals. And in a future video, we'll talk about the measurements and the tools that you would use to make this measurement. So one of the first things I want to talk about is breaking down conductivity versus infiltration, because we use these words interchangeably, and it's important to know that they don't mean the same thing. So here what you see on the left is a graph that shows a typical infiltration curve over time. And what you see is what we're measuring on the y-axis of this graph is the infiltration rate. Okay, so that's what we're typically measuring, is how fast water is actually infiltrating into the soil. And then what you see is over time is that that rate decreases and becomes more steady, and we reach what we call a quasi-steady state in the measurement. We measure the infiltration rate, which can vary depending on a lot of different things, to ultimately understand the hydraulic conductivity of the soil. And the hydraulic conductivity, what we define is a measure of the ability of a porous medium to transmit water. So in this case, being soil, typically. And so ultimately what we're doing is we're using this infiltration curve and then using these equations here to break that down and use the infiltration rate to calculate the hydraulic conductivity. Typically, we use the hydraulic conductivity to go back and put that into models and to actually try and understand and model how water moves through soil. And it is something that is a consistent value that we can use because it's independent of all the other factors that impact the ability of soil to transmit water or to infiltrate water. And to dive a little deeper into that, we really need to understand what are some of the factors that actually determine the value of hydraulic conductivity. So we have several things. We have soil texture that we know impacts hydraulic conductivity. We have soil structure, which is one of the critical pieces that I think sometimes we forget about, but plays one of the biggest roles in soil's hydraulic conductivity and how well it can infiltrate water. Biopores are things like wormholes and root decaying root channels, things like that. Those are also play a really big role in changing the hydraulic conductivity of soil. And then ultimately things like compaction and bulk density play a big role, as you can imagine. And then the initial water content or water potential of the soil also plays a big role, especially in expansive soils. It plays a much bigger role in expansive soils than maybe in non-expansive soils. So one of the other things we want to dive into as well is, why should we measure hydraulic conductivity? Why do we even care about this value? It impacts almost everything that soil is used for. It impacts crop production, especially when it comes to things like irrigation and drainage decisions. You know, one of our goals is to infiltrate water and have it stored in the root zone for the plants to be able to use it. And hydraulic conductivity plays a big role there, especially when it comes to irrigation and drainage versus water running off from the soil. It also impacts hydrology, both in native and urban environments. And this is one of the values, especially when we're trying to design systems to infiltrate water, we really need to understand this value. Landfill performance is another critical area. In some cases, we're trying to limit the ability of water to move into the soil. And in other cases, we're trying to store as much water into the cover as we can. And then, of course, we talked about this a little bit, stormwater system design, measuring the native soils and how they behave, and then trying to measure the soils that we're designing to infiltrate that water. Ultimately, our goal is to infiltrate more water and not have as much runoff. And as we improve soil health, we know that that improves things like the soil's ability to infiltrate and move water deeper into the profile. So there's some things that you need to understand when looking at hydraulic conductivity and making those measurements. And there's two ways that we break this up typically. We break it up into saturated hydraulic conductivity and unsaturated hydraulic conductivity. And here we have an example in this animation of two soils. One is infiltrating water under purely saturated conditions. That's why we have a psi of zero. It means the soil is saturated in unsaturated conditions. And what that means is that there's more trapped air. The soil isn't pulling on the water as much. And so there's actually less channels in the soil that are contributing to the flow. And so what that means is typically our hydraulic conductivity in unsaturated conditions is lower than that in saturated conditions. And so one of the tools that we use to help understand that is the hydraulic conductivity curve or hydraulic conductivity function. And here's a good example of what that looks like. And I want to show this for a few different soil types to really help you understand some of the things that we've just discussed. So here you see the infiltration curve for a poorly structured clay soil and what that looks like. And then we add that well-structured clay soil, and you can see how that changes as we get closer to saturation, how that curve shifts. And then we have another example here of a structureless sandy soil and what that infiltration curve looks like. And ultimately what we're trying to show here is, one, how as conditions become unsaturated, how that changes the hydraulic conductivity for the soil at different water potentials. And then as we get closer to saturation, the structure really starts to play a bigger role in the soil's ability to infiltrate water. And here you see that the clay, well-structured clay soil is actually able to infiltrate more water in saturated conditions than the structureless sandy soil. And so the point I want you to get across there is that soil texture is not the primary driver when it comes to saturated conditions. It's things like structure, it's things like the pores that are existing in the soil. And that's what this hydraulic conductivity function helps us understand about these soils.